call upon
these persons here present.
These persons here present.
To witness that I.
To witness that I.
William Oliver Robinson.
William Oliver Robinson.
Do take thee.
Do take thee.
Amy Louise Fitch.
Amy Louise Fitch.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
I call upon.
I call upon
these persons here present.
These persons here present.
To witness that I.
To witness that I.
Amy Louise Fitch.
Amy Louise Fitch.
Do take thee.
Do take thee.
William Oliver Robinson.
William Oliver Robinson.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
Amy, with this ring.
Amy, with this ring,
I promise.
I promise.
To love and care for you.
To love and care for you.
To comfort and protect you.
To comfort and protect you.
To listen and confide in you.
To listen and confide in you.
To respect your thoughts.
To respect your thoughts.
And your dreams.
And your dreams.
And to trust and believe in you.
And to trust and believe in you.
Above all others.
Above all others.
Will with this ring,
I promise,
to love and care for you,
to love and care for you,
to comfort and protect you,
to comfort and protect you,
to listen and confide in you,
to listen and confide in you,
to respect your thoughts,
to respect your thoughts,
and your dreams,
and your dreams,
and to trust and believe in you,
and to trust and believe in you,
above all others,
above all others.
My great pleasure and privilege to now tell you, husband and wife, and for the just a lucky bride.
. 1991 was a very fine year, for that's when our beautiful bride did suddenly appear. All through her formative years, we vowed never to let her down. But there was that one time at the school fete when we dressed her as a clown. Off to school she went, Higham Park, the avenues, and then on to the Hewitt. Finally to Roehampton University. Come on, Digby Stewart. Come on, thank you. Through the terrible twos, the funny fives, the time flew by, it seemed, until one day in February 2004, she turned into a teen. Dad, I need hair dye quick. Dad, I'm hungover, a McDonald's would really do the trick. Dad, I'm out in the city and I've lost my key and I can't find Jenna. Please come and rescue me. These are the little things that we all go through, many a life lesson learned. And now, who do I turn to when I'm in trouble? At last, the tide has turned. Over years, the odd boyfriend came and went, and there was one very odd one. Till I get a call one day, Dad, I've met a true gent. Where, says I? Oh, she says, out clubbing in Ibiza. Oh my God, I think to myself, what will become of her? I picture a loud lager lout with baseball cap and shiny waxed chest. That's where I stopped because I didn't dare to imagine all the rest. Then Will turns up, and oh, what a relief. A nicer guy you really couldn't wish to meet. But I was right about the baseball cap, and I didn't know about the chest until I saw the pictures, and now I do. So I thought, let's get to know this guy. Put out a few feelers. But wait, Amy, stop. Look no further. This man likes wheeler-dealers. Here we are at Luton Hugh, 7 years later on. And as they say, I'm not losing a daughter, but instead, I'm gaining a son. But actually, I prefer to see it rather as not me gaining a son, but Will, another father. Stop him, he's running. But the best thing, oh dear, here we go. I might need this. But the best thing is that at last I get to say out loud how beautiful a person you are, my darling, and how much you make me proud. Compose myself. And as you start your married life, my only advice to you, Will, is put that guy on speed dial who repairs your alloy wheels. Now my poem draws to a close, and you all sigh not a second too soon. But please stand with me and raise a glass to the bride and groom, Amy and Will.
Amy. All the blood that I will bleed.